Hi students, welcome to my class. How are you all? Okay, the next topic is estimation. Why we need to estimate things? For example, we are on a train and can we count the exact number of people in the train? It is impossible for us. So we say there were about 2,000 or 3,000 people in the train. Or last time when the cyclone came, the news we can hear around 200 people were dead in the cyclone. Okay, because they are using the word around because it is not the exact number. They are estimating to the nearest value. Okay, when we don't know the correct number, we estimate it as numbers. Okay, when we talk about stars, can you count the correct number? It is impossible. We say millions, billions of stars in the sky. Estimating numbers help us to do the calculation easily, so we can estimate numbers for the purpose of adding, subtracting, multiplying or dividing. Okay, I will explain you estimation with some simple examples. Here we have two numbers, 12 and 18. Let's see how we can estimate these numbers to its nearest zeros. Okay, these are two digit numbers, so we need to estimate it to its two digit numbers only. What we need to do is, first we need to check the last numbers. Here it is 2. 2 is between 0 to 5. 0 to 5. So we need to estimate this number to 10. If the number is bigger than 5, we need to estimate it to the next digit. That is, here it is 18. So we need to 18, and this number is 8. So we need to estimate it to 20. Do you understand? Okay, now how can we estimate this number? Here it is 1. So we can estimate it to its nearest 2 digit number, that is 80. Estimate to tens. Okay, next, this is a 3 digit number. How can we estimate this number? It is 43. Which is the number nearest to 43? Is it 50 or 40? In the scale, we know 40 up to 50. 43 is nearest to 40. So we estimate this number to 840. Then we can multiply this number. Like this, we can do addition, multiplication, subtraction. Okay, here is a question. Here we need to multiply this number after estimating it to its nearest value. Let's see how we can do this. Now we can easily find out the value. In the answer, we know that in the answer we will get 20. So let's put that 20, because here is a 0 and here is a 0. Then we want to multiply 8 with 4. 8 4 is 32. 3. 3 remainder. 8 is 64. 64 plus 3. 67. This is the answer. Okay. Brackets. Okay. Let's see why we use brackets. We have a question. 8 into 10 plus 6 into 10. Here we have
10 in both places. That is, here we have two operations, totally three operations, multiplication, addition and multiplication. But we want to multiply this with 10 and this with 10. Can we do this easily with a bracket? Yes, we can do this easily with a bracket. Let's see how we can add these two numbers and multiply with this common number, which is 10. So we easily get our answer, which is 8 plus 6, 14 into 10, 140. Otherwise, we need to do this like our normal operation, which is 8 into 10, 80, and 6 into 10, what is it? 60. Then we need to calculate this. Which one do you felt easy? This one, because here the numbers are small, so multiplication is easy. So this is an example where we can use bracket. Let's see another way of using brackets, that is expanding with brackets. Here we want to multiply 7 with 108, but this number is multiplying this number is a little difficult. You can do it, but it is a little difficult task. So for a easy method, we can do this like this. 7 into 100 plus 7 into 8. Okay, so here we can easily multiply a number with 100. We get 700 plus 7 into 8, 56. We got our answer 756. So it is a method of using bracket by expanding. Okay.
Okay, next topic is Roman numerals. Up to now, we have been using the Hindu system of numbers, then the Arabic system. Now we need to study about the Roman numerals also, because Roman numerals are used nowadays also in some places. Like we can see the Roman numerals in some clocks. We are even using it in our school to represent our classes, timetable, etc. So let's learn some properties of Roman numerals.
System. The first rule is, if a symbol is repeated, its value is added as many times as it occurs. Okay, for example, we are writing symbol 1. The value of 1 is, sorry, value of I is 1. And when we put 2i, the value is, what is the value? It is said that in this first rule, if the symbol is repeated, the value is added. That is, value of 1 is, I is 1, the 2i means 2. Similarly, let's see another example. Here we know that value of x is 10. So here also the number is symbol is repeated. So the value will be, what is the value? 20, because we have 2x, so 10 plus 10, that is 20. Okay, second rule. A symbol is not repeated more than 3 times, but the symbols V, L and D are never repeated. That is, the symbols V, L, D are never repeated in a number. Okay, and one more thing, we can use the other symbols 3 times, but can't use it more than 3 times repeatedly. Okay. Third rule. If a symbol of smaller value is written to the right of a symbol of greater value, its value gets added to the value of the greater symbol. Okay, let's see this with an example. Here, the symbol is written to the right of the greater value. So, which is the greater value? It is, here we know that we have greater value, which is 5, and I have the lesser value, that is 1. So here we need to add the values of the symbol to get the answer. So 5 plus 1, that is 5 plus 1, we get 6 as the answer. Okay, let's see some bigger example. Here also, we know that value of L is 50, X is 10 and V is 5. So here also, the same rule applies. So the value will be, what will be the value? Value will be, we will get the value by adding the numbers. So value of L, 50 plus value of X, 10 plus value of V, 5, that is 65. We get the answer as 65. Okay. Hope you understand. Okay, fourth rule. Okay, let's see what the fourth rule is. If a symbol of a smaller value is written to the left of a symbol of greater value, its value is subtracted from the value of the greater symbol. It is said that if it is written to the left of the greatest value, that is, here we know that we have greater value 5 and I have lesser value 1. It is written to the left. Here we need to subtract to get the answer. That is, subtract it from the greater value. That is, value of V is 5. And I is, what is the value of I? 1. The answer is 4. Let's see another example also. XC. Here, where C is the greater value, 100, and X have 10. Here also, the same rule applies. So we need to apply 100 minus 100 minus 10, which is 100 minus 10. The answer is 90. Okay. Okay. Fifth rule. The symbols V, L, D are never written to the left of a symbol of greater value. That is, V, L, D are never subtracted. Okay, what is it said? That is that the symbols V, L and D are never written to the left of a symbol. That is, it is never used here. That is, if this is an example, it is not, V is not written here. Okay, and the symbols I can be, symbol I can be subtracted from V and X only. That is, the symbol I can be subtracted from V and X only. And one more thing, the symbol X can be subtracted from L, M and C only. So you need to study this rule for doing your problems. Okay.
Okay, so we have finished our first chapter. Stay safe. Thank you.